On today's show, we're going to talk about productivity secrets of the super successful. Creating wealth, protecting families, building legacy. This is the Rich Life Lawyer Show. Hey everybody, this is, welcome to, gosh, can't even remember my own introduction. Welcome to episode 14 of the Rich Life Lawyer Show. As always, I'm your host, Christopher Small. I'm excited to be here with you today where we talk about productivity secrets of the super wealthy, super productive, super successful, whatever you want to say. These are some of the things that people do that get a lot done and get a lot done fast, so they have time to do the other things that they want. All right, let's talk about it. So these productivity secrets are secrets that I myself use, not to say that I am super successful or super wealthy, although I may or may not be, depends on who you ask, but this is how it goes. So first things first, I do a thing every Sunday. I call it a Sunday pregame. Stole this from my friend, Andrew Norman, who is also a super, super productive person, gets a lot done, really accomplishes his goals and sort of gets after it. Really like Andrew. But what you do there is you basically kind of plan out your week. Okay, so hopefully you have some goals that you're working toward. Whether they be yearly goals or quarterly goals, which you back down into the monthly goals, and then you can back that into your week. So you can say, you know, what do I need to do this week to reach my goals, my big goals, or my monthly goals? And you figure that out, and then it doesn't all just end there, though, okay? What you do is you try to plot it out, think about what you want to do on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, given the fact that you have to work, given the fact that you have meetings at work and things like that, and then you begin to arrange your schedule so that you get 6 things done every day. Only 6. All you care about is 6. You're gonna get 6 things done. You're gonna write these down. Okay, so Monday, you wanna get these 6 things done. And the way that I do it is, on that Sunday pregame, I don't necessarily map out everything I wanna do day by day. I definitely pick out what I wanna have done on Monday. And then typically on Monday night, I'll look at the Sunday pregame list and I'll figure out what I wanna do and get done on Tuesday. But you figure out these 6 things, you write them down, okay? Then you look at each thing and you figure out how much time it's gonna take you to get done. If it's a big project, then you wanna break down what step you're gonna do that day to get the project done. Map that time out. All the time of those 6 things should not be more than like 6 hours, okay? Because that's the true amount of productive time you're gonna have in a day, because you're gonna have people messing with you, you're gonna have people popping in, you have all this kind of stuff. You're gonna want to then, once you do that, once you take that time, then you wanna take those activities and actually input them into your calendar. Even if you are the only one that's doing something, say you're reviewing a document or you're creating something, put that on your calendar. And then when that time comes, the next day, you do it. You also, it's important to schedule in what I call water cooler time, right? So time you're gonna check your email, time you want to talk to coworkers. I would also then schedule in specific time to return calls. Typically, I do it between 11:30 and 12, or 11 and 12, and then 4 and 5. So twice a day, I just block out some time to return any phone calls that I need throughout the day. I'll also block out typically a half hour, maybe like at 10:30, and a half hour at 2:30 to check email, and then everything else goes in the middle. And then, what you do is you have one rule every day, that is just to follow that calendar. Just do what it says, get to work, don't mess around, and get the stuff done. If you follow that productivity tip right there, I guarantee you, your productivity, your what you put out will skyrocket. Your effectiveness will skyrocket. The amount of open time that you have will skyrocket, because what will happen is you'll get stuff done, you'll say like, okay, now what do I do, right? Because there's this rule, I can't remember what it's called, where you fill the time allotted for something, right? Like if you have an hour for a meeting, you'll go sit in the meeting for an hour, even if you could have been done in 15 minutes. So those are some big productivity tips. I'll leave you with one more productivity tip, and that is to eliminate needless interruptions. Okay, and this is particularly true if you have a staff or if you have people that come to you with questions. What you want to let them know is like, look, I want to answer your questions and I want to help you, but I only want to do it at this time. Okay, so if you have a question that pops up, instead of coming into my office and wrecking my concentration and the things that I've been working on, write them all down. And then at 11 o'clock to 11:30 is question time. You can come in there anytime you want, open office, and we'll talk, right? But otherwise, I'm going to be working on projects of myself that I don't want to be interrupted on. And it's not a mean thing, right? This isn't coming from a place of spite or anger. It's really about, look, this is the best way for us to both utilize that time. This is the way that I can give you my full attention. So let's try this and see how it works. All right, so question of the day, what I want from you is, what is your best productivity tip? Tell me, because I'm always looking for them. So leave a comment below. Remember, if you have questions, I can answer them. Twitter, @richlifelawyer. Go to facebook.com/richlifelawyer. Just leave a hashtag, #richlifelawyershow, to make sure that I can find them when I'm searching, and I'll answer them. So, have a great day. See you.